Hello, friends. We've done this previously. Jayar Jackson is an LA native. He's not the biggest Lakers fan, but he does know a thing or two about Julius Randle. So Tanya Ganguly from the from Lakers Nation, I was gonna say the LA Times, I'm sorry, Lakers Nation. Randle's situation is worth watching though. The Lakers would love to trade him if they could, and Jordan Clarkson fits in that category too. Both players know they have been offered in trades and they're handling it in different ways. And then Adrian Wojnarowski said, one player whose future very unlikely, Julius Randle. Rob Pelinka, the GM, Magic Johnson, the Prez, will be faced with this question. Do they look to trade Randle between now and the February trade deadline and get back potentially a first round draft pick for him? That's highly unlikely, by the way. Or do they roll the dice and wait until the summer when he's a restricted free agent? Yeah, that's the thing. He's a restricted free agent, so you don't have to offer a first round pick right now, is my point. He's on a 1 year deal, man. He's done after this year. So here's something else from Rob Lopez and Woj put out. There was a deal that was being discussed between Julius Randle and Nerly Noel. I say Nerly, not Nerlens. But nothing came of it. That's fine. Here's my point.
Where's Nerlens, by the way?
Dallas. Oh. So here's my point. Get somebody that is going to be on an expiring contract or a young player that has a long contract that doesn't pay him a lot. And that's where I came from with these. So here are the trades. I want you to react to these. Greg Monroe for Jordan Clarkson and Julius Randle. You're giving up a lot, but you don't want Clarkson anymore. You're trying to clear space for LeBron, Paul George, and company. You get Greg Monroe for 1 year. Maybe if he likes the culture and what they're building, he will take a lesser contract.
Greg Monroe is getting paid.
Yeah, he is getting paid.
Wow.
Detroit and help me out. Detroit and Milwaukee. He's paying him. Out of the ass, man.
Jesus, man. Greg Monroe is winning.
He's got a great agent.
Jesus. I was looking at the numbers, of course, when we were assessing his trade, and my brain stopped moving after I saw $17 million Greg Monroe. Yeah, I was like, is that the contract salary?
I don't know if people are going to hate me or love me for this joke, but he has the same agent as Nick Cannon.
Oh. Well, Nick Cannon's getting paid too.
Yeah, that's my point. I don't know what they do. I don't know why they're successful when it comes to the dollars. He had a good show in like the late 90s, early 2000s, and now he's just riding the coattails of divorcing Mariah Carey and MTV. And he was a ring announcer for boxing, and I could not understand why. He also, it seems, doesn't understand the National Basketball Association.
Really?
But he was the host of All-Star Game Weekend. I was dumbfounded by these decisions.
No, NBA
we are available. Do you know who we are?
No, no, because they wanted an entertainment thing. NBA playoffs. NBA All-Star Game. Nick Cannon. They just wanted it to be this loud yelling announcer guy.
Right.
And the thing is, they need one for this generation. There's no maybe there's a couple, but this standard announcer guy. And Nick Cannon's
agent. So DeAndre, you gotta get a 10 here. Man, give me a fucking break. This guy gets paid crazy.
I can't hate on him, man. If he's getting his money, someone's gonna pay him.
But you're hating on Greg Monroe.
Well, it's not
my money.
I'm like, congratulations, Greg. I wish I'd have figured out how to do this.
More trades.
By the way, that first trade, come on. Lakers gonna take that on? How many years? Greg Monroe's got one left?
They're trying to clear room for Paul George, LeBron James, Chris Paul. Get the Banana Boat crew together. They could go out on Manhattan Beach. They could hang out with some of our peeps at TYT. I was about to slip up. I'm glad I didn't. Lakers and Pelicans. Here's another one. DeMarcus Cousins and Omer Asik for Kentavious Caldwell-Pope again on a 1 year deal. Jordan Clarkson and Julius Randle. With the entire thought process that you will get Boogie to stay because
That's who you want.
Yeah, you obviously want
him. And you want to make the core group that you may be going to have another potential superstar free agent come in to want to play with.
The reason I don't love that deal, if we could show it one more time, is that Omer Asik is on a 3 year deal. What you're trying to do is clear cap space. Yeah. Once again, clear.
And Omer is making 10. Just over 10.
He's making 10.5 and he doesn't know which basket to shoot in. He's got no offense. The Lakers and the Kings. This is one that I do like because you get a younger player. You're swapping Kentucky big men. This deal will only be in place if Sacramento. If Julius Randle will agree with Sacramento to sign on long term, or else obviously you don't do it. But for the Lakers, you get a role playing big who could rebound. And you get him on a team-friendly deal.
Oh, Julius would be so upset.
He would be so upset. But then again, it's the Kings. So, it's the Kentucky Kings at this point.
Wow.
Julius Randle being traded to the Milwaukee Bucks. Basically, what you're getting is Thon Maker.
Mm-hmm.
and you really don't know what you have yet. He could be like the seventh man for a team, but again, it's a team-friendly deal. Thoughts?
Like no? there's stuff with all these, but I mean, again, I think as you said in the beginning, it might be best to sit on him with Julius apparently with the Lakers and see what you can do with him. I mean,
don't you want to get something instead of him walking?
Well,
there's no way that you sign him. He wants to get paid, man, and he should get paid.
That's true.
He's a good player, so you want to get anything in return for him. Which one am I on here? The Lakers and the Blazers. This is another trade that I like because I just like somehow finding a way of Julius Randle being on Portland because they need a Julius Randle. You got two great players in CJ McCollum and Dame. Mm-hmm. And then, you know, Nurkic is pretty good. I think he's probably going to leave at some point. So I like Julius Randle going to the Blazers. Do I have any more? Is that it? That's it. Okay. We are out of time. So what have we learned?
We've learned that, this particular deal.
No, just the entire show. It doesn't matter.
Oh, concussions don't matter.
Concussions don't matter to Roger Goodell.
That's the main thing we've learned.
Nick Cannon's overrated.
Well, Nick Cannon's getting paid.
And the Blazers should trade for Julius
Randle.
That's
the one I did like.
The Blazers?
That's the only one I liked.
I like the Blazers getting both players, actually. No. We're going to save the Clarkson trades for tomorrow.
Yeah.
We'll be back. Yeah. Literally then.